I don't know how many times we can tell you that. They're so sophisticated these days. You can program them county by county. Specific warnings. You won't be woken up by something that's 300 miles away anymore.
Yeah.
It's just perfect science.
Well, you can't say it enough, really.
Right, exactly.
You can't say it enough, especially where we live.
You're right, absolutely.
Yeah, and you've had storms in the state today.
Yes.
Some of them have been a little rocky.
Well,
but
we'll take what we can get.
Yeah.
I mean, they're not going to be high-end storms. We need the rain. You just did the story about the drought. I've got good news. We got isolated storms in the forecast through Sunday. Now, there will actually even be better chances in eastern Oklahoma, but for our part of the state, just isolated. I tell you what, though, the humidity over the weekend is going to be brutal, and the heat is not going to be going anywhere as well. Temperatures across the region, just a little bit of rain-cooled air in eastern, east-central Oklahoma, so the upper 70s there. Everyone else generally still well into the 80s. 85 of the metro. Our high today was 97. It's 81 right now up in Edmond, 82 for our friends in Midwest City, with Shawnee coming in at 81. Winds have been pretty light all day. There's been a breeze here or there, but in general, the winds have been less than 10 miles an hour. All right, look at Advantage Doppler 3D. A couple of showers in north central Oklahoma kind of fizzled out as it got towards the Enid area. Of course, western Oklahoma was dry. The highest concentration of storms was in northeast Oklahoma, and they kind of carried towards the I-40 corridor before dissipating. I anticipate this kind of scenario again for tomorrow. Good concentration of storms in the eastern part of the state, then isolated storms across our eastern viewing area, perhaps trying to sneak towards the I-35 corridor late into the afternoon hours. The last shower has now pretty much obliterated, and that is in southern portions of Pontotoc County, but it is said and done. Lows overnight falling back down into the lower 70s, and again, it'll be a pretty humid start to the day. Then highs for tomorrow, we had a couple of triple digits. Enid got there, Stillwater got there, and tomorrow we can get close in many areas. I think Alva will be one of those spots that probably goes above 100 degrees. 71 degrees. The sky is clear out tonight. We'll be 75 tomorrow morning. Again, light winds for your Saturday. It'll already be steamy by noon at 89. A high tomorrow with a metro of 96. But the humidity will be in full blast for tomorrow with those light southeast winds. But again, we do have storm chances out there. I'm going to generally put them east of I-35 through Sunday. This is isolated, a scattered variety. Yes, some could slip close to the metro. It would be fantastic. Unfortunately, out in western Oklahoma, I don't think that you'll have a real good chance at all for any rain. And unfortunately, that will not just be through the weekend, but probably through most of next week. The best storm chances are through Monday. And then after that, we might cut off the rain for the entire state. Notice how highs on Sunday fall a little bit, but that is at the expense of higher humidity values. So that's the reason why the temperatures can't climb as high. But I promise you, it will feel just as hot on Sunday as it will for tomorrow. So no break in the heat through the weekend. Hot, humid with light winds. Again, an isolated storm is not out of the question. Same thing on Sunday as well. These will be cropping up in the afternoon. Heavy downpours and some lightning, then they'll die back down during the early evening hours. Same scenario on Monday, the high 94. Rest of the 7-day forecast as we dry out. It's going to get hotter, guys. I think we're going to be pushing the upper 90s with many locations across the state, getting close to 100 again by next Wednesday. And you're up to date with the latest First Alert forecast.